Hey, when I'm watching this episode of One Piece, this is episode 2, The Man with Straw Hat. Alright, let's get started. I thought I was gonna be previously on then. I'm surprised not a lot of people are, freaked out by his powers. Goodness. And now that's what it means. Wow. True words, but at least he knows. That's our silence. The map. So why is she looking then? Is the map inside of that thing, or? The circus. Yes, I have a sword. Thank you. Ha ha ha. She's spotted. Cadet. She's up in the sense. Thank you. Oh. Not chance. So that he pissed him off. I was not expecting that. Does everyone know everyone? That's a weird snail. You just seem loyal towards the Marines. Oh, that's helpful. as myself. Oh my gosh. Very interesting. swimming. I love that. I see the tears on his eyes. What's she doing? All right, episode 2. That was actually really fun to watch. Have a nice touch of one name from the previous episode, and then when I saw that in credits, and then said that dude from Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. so I recognized him, so that's cool. This character was cool. I feel like in the beginning of the episode, that clown pirate and Luffy knew that Luffy's old friend, you know, so back then, and then there was a lot of things that happened within the backstory, more of Luffy and his friend that we actually got to know of them more and understand that there was more fruits out there that gave other people special abilities, and a clown dude ate one of them and he's able to have his body reshape himself. Luffy is always, he's seen the same thing, however he really shows that he's passionate about being the pirate king and the king of the pirate and having himself become the best there is so that he can be who he wants to be. And I feel like the clown dude Bergy said about who he idolizes and how it all comes together on why he is the way he is. Since he was a kid, he looked up to his friend who gave him the hat, and I feel that it's part of him. It's a bit promised to be the best pirate he could be for himself and for his friend, and now it makes sense to do so. So Even though the Baki character was a little, he was a bad guy in this episode. I feel like with knowing that knowledge, it really helped him and understand more about himself with being the best there is, and then thing of him swallowing the map. That was sounds better, yeah. Now me and Zoro were taken to the green room, and basically they didn't like the way they planned themselves and the way they didn't really work as a team, really, because they don't see themselves as a team. And for the beginning of the episode, but then towards the end, those two understand their ways to be the way they are. So it wasn't, he's not a big fan of planning escapes or anything like that, but and also Nami isn't interested in, you know, causing mayhem, you know, like Zoro, but then they saw each other's perspectives and used that to help Luffy and to get the map back and free the people in the tent, you know, there, and the town being destroyed was unexpected for Nami, and then she feels really bad and about that. It really helped her understand that it was something that she had to do, is help everyone. And on top of that, she has the map in the end of the episode, but then she contacts someone else. So, and there's a snail, so maybe she's working for the marine dudes, maybe that's a spy or not, maybe that's me speculating. And probably the possibility that she's a spy for the marines, but then it's all in the area right there. And then this thing about the episode with the dude who's a cadet, and there's a little bit, he's very loyal for himself being a marine, and in the ending of the first episode, they told Luffy that they were going to, if they ever meet again, he would be the enemy, to be each other's enemies, and Luffy understood that, and so did the cadet did, and then, yeah, that was something that really helped him throughout his way, and the fact that he has to do his job of him going to the Grand Line and stabbing Luffy and all that stuff. Really, the location and the set pieces there looks very cool. I love how it looks so parody and stuff. That's very fun. See, oh, this was a nice episode. I really enjoyed it. The dinner with Shanks losing one arm, he was really unexpected. However, he's more caring and focused on the safety of Luffy, which I really appreciate, and then they talk to each other about the hat, and then, yeah, was a perfect way to see what's happening next, and but that it shows that he's out there somewhere, and probably in the Grand Line, and now me, it's another thing of me speculating, is that he's probably already there, and because he's been out for years, so who knows what he's been up to, and who knows what he's been doing, so, or if he's been captured, you know, how long, you know, it depends how that is. So I'm interested in seeing what would happen if they ever meet up again or anything like that. If him and Luffy ever meet up. Watching this show is actually really fun for me, and I actually enjoying it. So thank you for being here. I appreciate all of you watching, and I'll see you for the next one. Take care. Bye.